access to abortion or contraception. It's a profoundly first punch of money. And you could sit by and say, well, I really want to get along. You guys are rolling back the clock. And you can stand tall. Seriously. And the reason I started to go into real estate, the reason I started taking this office, and the reason I started doing ads in these real estates, is I didn't know my partner was doing enough. It was CRT, and then it's ESG, it's DEI. These were three letters. And they're shapeshifting. And they're trying to. And so, but it's true, right? And I just thought there was a little timidity in our party. And I thought we needed all this stuff. These guys have been on bandage crisis. You want to talk about cancer? That's Bud Light, Target, Disney, that's just a private sector. Banning speech, not in just my classroom, but in the boardroom as it relates to issues of race. Look what they've done, 3,363 books just last year for a ban. This is a serious and consequential moment. It's a cultural purge. And so I just felt like we needed to call that out as Democrats and put them on the horizon since we're consistently on our heels as a Democratic Party, even though I think the facts they have on are significantly better than the case on the other side. But again,
and again, even Bill Maher's in the silence of criticism, which people don't understand coming from Bill Maher. But again, it's kind of this legendary joke. But listen, Governor Newsom is exactly correct. And listen, I understand that a lot of people don't like Governor Newsom. I don't live in California. I don't live in California. And my knowledge of California is statewide policy is relatively limited. But what I will say, which I don't think is controversial at all, shouldn't be for those of us from our center left to far left, those of us who are not Republicans and conservatives and don't consider themselves centrists, the energy and rhetorical style and approach that Newsom brings to the Democratic Party is good. I have not seen any compelling evidence or argument to the contrary. And listen, he's right. And I think the way that he answered the question is great because he said, well, listen, ideally, we wouldn't have us versus them in time. It's hard. But we have to push that because Republicans constantly, from Donald Trump, Marjorie Taylor Greene, Ron DeSantis, Brett Abbott, you name it, basically every major Republican leader has constantly deemed blue states, blue cities. Jim Jordan constantly puts it on his Twitter talking about how Chicago Democratic run cities, how their hellscapes and everything else. Why is it okay for Republicans and conservative thought leaders to speak so with such hostility, but quite frankly, a majority of the country, why is it okay for them to demonize and to dehumanize and to speak so harshly of tens of millions of people, more people that are on their side, but it's not okay for Gavin Newsom and others to kind of push back, especially, listen, we're going to do it. Let's compare red states and blue states. Let's compare which states generally make themselves better educated, more healthy, less dependent on federal subsidies, all the things. By those metrics, by and large, red states do worse than blue states. These are simply facts. And Ben Shapiro all tells us. This asymmetry has got to stop. It is irrational, it's illogical, it's immoral, and it's also politically inexpedient. It allows the Republicans and the government to punch above their weight class because they can effectively dish it out, but they're never in a position where they have to take it. Like they're that person on the playground who shut you down, but then you go to shut them back, and you make them out of the danger. Even though they were the ones who struck first, and then second, and third, and fourth. And this is just something I feel very passionate about. I think that the Democratic cause, and the progressive cause, the general self-set up in a particular part of politics aside, but the broader ideology, it's inherently challenging. Being on the left, but being a lion, is part of the logical speaking. And hopefully speaking more to the right, because you're constantly pushing for change, and change requires effort, energy, and power. Right? Whereas conservatives basically just resting on morals, relativism. And so we're making that job so much harder. And we also say they get to say and do whatever they want. We have to constantly mind our manners and watch our words. It doesn't even matter when the president gives a speech. You know, 2 years ago at Independence Hall, extreme map of Republicans. He got over backwards to say that it wasn't good. All Republicans were even most Republicans, and they still can vote that speech. And most Americans actually found a speech to this because we all crave Republicans in the White House. We have to. to stop doing it. This was something from the Fox Propaganda Network and Harris Faulkner. That would make me feel important. And she talks about what side in her opinion is really important.
Their hate toward the 75 million people and their online together called MAGA. Their hate toward the former president, and they'll go with him, go after him with everything he's done. Pretty soon, doesn't hate have to be greater love? I mean, you got to
And apparently the guy here, the older gentleman, is apparently like a former Democratic strategist. And he's like, yeah, absolutely, I completely agree. It's like, okay, let's take everything you said at face value. Let's say the left hates 75 million voters. The right hates 82 million people. The 82 million who voted for Joe Biden. Why is that okay? And you talk about hating the president? What about Let's Go Brandon, FJB? What about the hate that's being directed at President Biden from the MAGA movement and the Republican Party? Why don't you care about that? And especially because the Fox Network used to be all about, you're supposed to be a knight of the Republicans. You're supposed to be in control of party engagement. Like that was what they always told us when President Bush was in the to help when Donald Trump was in office. But again, apparently it's only the Republicans. When you do that, you can be as mean and divisive as you want. You have to be knight behind the president. Asymmetry is despicable. And Jessica Tarlov actually threw that in the face of all people, Kayleigh McEnany, the blonde there, who used to work for Donald Trump. This is her second time. I love what Jessica Tarlov has to say. People want me to be nicer to the Republican Party, then they must repeat their vicious verb, demand that the Republican Party serve me. This is not a one-way street. I refuse to accept that. And so should you. Absolutely. And when you're in conversations with people, whether it's family debates, even in person, you should also do that. If you want civility back in politics, The West Wing is one of my favorite shows. You want, then Republicans have to do it too. Republicans need to start showing respect to President Biden. They need to start showing respect to the Democratic Party. They need to show respect to the left-wing community, to marginalized groups, to minorities and women and LGBTQ communities. We have to start doing that. What we're not going to do, and what we should never allow, is a one-sided civility in which only the right, MAGA, Republicans benefit. I am all for the regression of Gavin Newsom's Democratic Party is going to pick that up with a quickness in the near future. Let me know what you think.
Thank you. The story is about a one man people ship, Hudson's story, who has lost all hope for his future. He was born into a family where he grew up with only love and freedom of his parents, but he said nothing. After losing his mother and his parents, his father lost the remaining expectations he had. Though he feels dominant to have been useless now, his father didn't want him to be a part of that family. So he canceled his schooling and sent him to their villa at the deep mountains. As days pass by, the loneliness, negative thoughts, and depression. He wonders how easy it would be for him to just sleep and simply never wake up. One night in a cold winter, someone knocks on the door. He goes to check and sees it's a girl who wants him to marry. Her name is Yuzu, and she is sent by Kiko's father. No one from a common family would give their daughter to Kiko, so his father bought a bride. Knowing she must have traveled here in this harsh weather, Kiko gives his cloak to her.
Thank you. for us. Thank you. just wait 4 seconds. Maybe it shots.
Maybe faster.
Should be making it stomach. Thank you. Bolt. This should be better. Something we should look into. Well, let's fly kind of randomly. Yeah. Got a locked up plane. Where's your body? Locked up location. This is a good place to stop.